Good morning and welcome to our online morning worship for Sunday the 9th of May, which is the sixth Sunday of Easter. As you'll be aware, some of the congregations will be worshipping together this morning within the St James building, and they will also be following the order for morning worship. So today our two services will coincide, co-align with each other. But because we are at home and because we are allowed to sing within our own homes, we can start by singing the lovely hymn, Angel Voices Ever Singing. If you haven't already joined in with that, then please do the usual. Click out of this video, onto the link in the email or in the box under the video. Sing the hymn and come back and join us as we begin our worship. Alleluia! Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia!
Let us worship God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
We will rejoice and be glad in it.
So let's pray together.
Lord, direct our thoughts and teach us to pray. Lift our hearts to worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
And as always, when we begin our worship, we start by recollecting the past days and weeks and bringing before God those things where we know we have fallen short of what he wanted us to do and be, either as individuals or as part of the broader human race. So let's just take a moment now as we call to mind those things and prepare to come to God to seek his forgiveness. Jesus says, repent, for the kingdom of God is close at hand. So let us turn away from sin and turn to the Lord, confessing our sins in penitence and faith. So we pray together. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen.
May Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon us. Pardon and deliver us from all our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen. So as God's forgiven people, let's praise his name. Let everything be said and done in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Giving thanks to God through Jesus Christ.
Sing psalms, hymns, and sacred songs.
Let us sing to God with thankful hearts.
Open our lips, Lord,
and we shall praise your name.
And the psalm this morning we're going to use to praise God's name is truly a psalm of praise. As always, Paul and I will take alternate verses. Please join in or listen as you wish. Psalm 98. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvellous things.
His own right hand and his holy arm have won for him the victory.
The Lord has made known his salvation. His deliverance has he openly shown in the sight of the nations.
He has remembered his mercy and faithfulness towards the house of Israel, and all the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God.
Sound praises to the Lord, all the earth. Break into singing and make music.
Make music to the Lord with the lyre and the voice of melody.
With trumpets and the sound of the horn, sound praises before the Lord, the King.
Let the sea thunder and all that fills it, the world and all that dwell upon it.
Let the rivers clap their hands, and let the hills ring out together before the Lord, for he comes to judge the earth.
In righteousness shall he judge the world, and the peoples with equity.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And so we pray together the Church's special prayer for today, the Collect. God, our Redeemer, you have delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of your Son. Grant that as by his death he has recalled us to life, so by his continual presence in us he may raise us to eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. So our first reading this morning continues our telling of the story of through the book of Acts. It's taken from Acts chapter 10 and is the story of what happened when Peter had been preaching to a group of people and they had acknowledged God and Jesus as Lord. While Peter was still speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who heard the word. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles, for they heard them speaking in tongues and extolling God. Then Peter said, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have?" So he ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they invited him to stay for several days.
And our Gospel reading is from the Gospel according to John, chapter 15. Continuing on from last week's passage, we're reading from verse 9 this week. So Jesus continues to speak to his disciples. "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you, so that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing, but I've called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. And now Paul is going to speak to us.
One of the first LPs I bought when I was still at school some 50 years ago was the LP Tapestry by Carole King. It was of course on vinyl. And although we have got a record player, I have to confess it's in the attic, along with a collection of LP records, including this one. Not much use if you want to listen to one. So I recently bought Tapestry again, this time on CD, so that I can play it on our CD player. There's a track on the album called "You've Got a Friend," and it goes a bit like this. "You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. Winter, spring, summer or fall, all you have to do is call, and I'll be there. You've got a friend." Friends are really important. Like mine, I'm sure some of your friendships go back years. School friends, college friends, work friends, neighbours. Maybe they're friendships that, even if you've not seen each other for a long time, you can pick things up exactly where you left off. Some of your friendships are more recent. I know some people in the congregation have made new friendships over this past year with those they've been speaking to on the phone each week. Old or new, friendships give us the opportunity to share with each other, to learn from each other, to support each other, and to get to know each other better. Unfortunately, the concept of friendship, which to me means an open, honest and living relationship, has been devalued somewhat with social media. Those of you who do Facebook will know that making someone a friend on Facebook doesn't imply any depth of relationship. My Facebook account says I've got 98 friends. Looking through the list, there are some very surprising people there, people that I'd never think of as my true friends. And 98 sounds quite a lot, but in Facebook terms, it's a paltry number. My daughter has nearly 500, some of whom I would guess she hardly knows. A true friend is surely someone who's always there for us, will always be ready to listen, to help, to encourage, to support, and to comfort, as well as someone with whom we can share joys and successes and achievements. I hope that you are fortunate to have such a true friend, or hopefully several. In our gospel reading today, Jesus talks about his disciples, and by extension us, being his friends. And there's an echo here with that wonderful story of Abraham in the Old Testament. Abraham, you recall, who's called God's friend. Abraham, who spoke with God face to face. Here's what Jesus says in that gospel reading. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing, but I've called you friends. Now that's quite an amazing thought, that we can be friends with Jesus, and hence, like Abraham, friends with God. So how can that be? How can we develop and deepen this friendship? How can our friendship with Jesus become one that will sustain us and refresh us and encourage us through good times and bad? Last week, you will recall that Jill was speaking to us about the close connection we can have with Jesus. Jesus used the picture of the vine to illustrate this. He is the vine, we are the branches. Now, it's impossible to say where a branch ends and a vine begins, because the branch is not only attached to the vine, it's actually part of the vine. This is the abiding in love that's being spoken about in the gospel reading, being part of the vine. If you abide in love, says Jesus, you will keep my commandments. If you keep my commandments, you will be my friends. So the friendship we can have with Jesus springs out of this close, connected relationship. So how then can we develop such a relationship? I guess it's like any friendship. Trust, time, commitment, love, shared thoughts. In Christian terms, when we're talking about these things in relation to God himself, we might call all of these things prayer. Because prayer is not just asking God for things. It's about resting in his presence. It's about enjoying spending time with him, praising, thanking, reading and studying, and simply being with him. It's about our faith, being not just for Sundays at church, but being for the whole of our lives, for all that we do and all that we are. Faith is about our Monday mornings and Thursday afternoons, our times with our families, at work and our leisure, being as much part of our worship and prayer life as our Sundays. But the key times are times when we intentionally spend time with God in prayer. Now, the thought of spending time in prayer might seem like a bit of a hard task. But think about it. Spending time with someone we love is never a burden. It's a joy. Think about the time you spend with those who are closest to you. Perhaps those that you've missed over these past few months in the lockdown. Your best friends, if you like. Spending time with them is an essential part of keeping that relationship alive and fresh. It's something we want to do. And it's the same with our relationship with God. So how can we do this? Of course, Sundays are vital in terms of our relationship with God and also with other Christians, the church. Being part of a group of Christians on the same journey, the same path as we are. Sharing our experiences, sharing our worship, our faith and our doubts. Growing together. But there are other possibilities too. Daily or other regular times set aside for scripture reading, prayer and response. Study groups. A great opportunity at the moment is the Pilgrim Course that we're starting on Thursday evening, looking together at the Lord's Prayer. It's not too late to join up, just have a word. Then there's Bible reading on our own. Various notes and reading aids are available to make this simpler and more meaningful. Margaret would love to help to get you started here. Talk to me or to her if you'd like some help. Each of us has to work out what's best for us. We're all different. Being outside in the country might do it for you. Inside a chapel or a church building. Maybe as you walk to the shops, spending time in your garden, or even doing the washing up. There'll be particular things that bring you closer to God. Prayer can be hard, but it's worth working at, as it helps us develop this friendship with God. The Church of England has long used the 10 days between Ascension Day and Pentecost as an opportunity to set aside time to pray. In recent years, our archbishops have encouraged this under the Thy Kingdom Come banner, picking up the familiar words from the Lord's Prayer. This year, we're distributing across the parish nearly 200 copies of a special prayer journal which Stephen Cottrell, the Archbishop of York, has put together. Hopefully you'll get yours before Ascension Day this coming Thursday, the 13th of May. For each day between Ascension and Pentecost, there'll be a short Bible reading, some thoughts from the Archbishop, a short prayer you might like to use, and some space for your own thoughts and prayers. Maybe after using this, you'll find your prayer life, your connection with God, just that little bit easier. The development of our relationship with God, our friendship with God, is not just to benefit ourselves. In an echo again of the vine image, Jesus talks of this closeness, this connection, enabling us to bear fruit, fruit that will last. Elsewhere in the New Testament, in Paul's letter to the church in Galatia, we have a beautiful description of what that fruit of the Spirit is. The fruit of the Spirit, he says, is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. This is the love that Jesus spoke about, but in action, in our lives, in our families, in our neighbourhoods, in our churches, in our communities. This is the love in action that can change the world. But we don't produce this fruit by our own effort. It's not just a case of trying harder. It comes from being part of the vine. It all flows from our connection with God. The closer our relationship, the more intimate our friendship, the more fruitful we become. And just like an apple tree can only produce apples, and apples can only come from an apple tree, so the fruit, the way we live, will reflect our being connected with God. The fruit will be lives more like the life that Jesus lived. The best human friendships we have are those friendships which enable us to become better people, enable us to reach our full potential. And the same applies to our friendship with God. By being connected with the source of all life, we can be strengthened and changed into becoming the best we can be. We can be filled with God's Spirit as we begin to bear fruit by who we are and what we do. We can have his life and his love within us. We can live as he wants us to live.
Thank you, Paul. There are many things to think about and reflect on in that sermon this morning. And as we do so, we're going to sing the hymn, Love Divine.
Excelling joy of heaven to earth come down, fixing us thy humble dwelling, all thy faithful mercies crown. Jesus, thou art all compassion, pure unbounded love. Thou art visit. eternity.
We come to affirm our faith in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and we'll do that this morning in the responsive version. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
We believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the Church.
This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God,
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And so let us share the peace of God. We are all one in Christ Jesus. We belong to him through faith, heirs of the promise of the Spirit of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
So let's share with one another a sign of peace. Peace be with you.
And with you.
Our prayers this morning are led for us by Jill Hanton. Let us pray.
Good morning. Today we're going to pray for some people and situations needing God's loving care. If you have a piece of paper and a pen to hand, please draw two lines, one top to bottom, one left to right, to create four squares to write in. When I say, Lord, in your mercy, would you respond, hear our prayer? In the top left square, I invite you to write down something that you're grateful for. Perhaps the love of family or friends, your health, or anything that you like. Loving God, thank you for all the good things I experience in my life. Help me always to remember to be grateful. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In the top right square, I invite you to write down one of your own needs that you want to bring to God. It could be a grief that you're carrying, something you're worried about, something big or something small. Lord, you know all our needs. Please help us with these concerns we are bringing to you today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In the bottom left square, I invite you to write down something you'd like to pray for in our nation. Perhaps remembering our NHS staff, our teachers, or our leaders. God of the nations, show your mercy to our nation now, and bless those who serve us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Finally, in the bottom right square, I invite you to write down the names of people you know who you know need God's love at this time. Perhaps someone who is unwell, someone who is bereaved, someone who needs hope or to hear the good news. Lord, you healed the sick and cared for the hurting. Be with these people that we bring before you today. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Thank you, Lord, that you hear all these prayers which we make in Jesus' name. Amen. Perhaps keep your piece of paper and add to it over the next few days, bringing all these needs to God in prayer. Each time you use it or add to it, pray, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. I invite you now to join in the prayer that Jesus himself gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, Jill. So as we come towards the conclusion of our service, we pray together our sending out prayer. Eternal God, our beginning and our end, accompany us on this day's journey. Dawn on our darkness, open our eyes to praise you for your creation and to see the work you set before us today. Take us and use us to bring to others the new life you give in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord God Almighty is our Father.
He loves and tenderly cares for us.
The Lord Jesus Christ is our Saviour.
He has redeemed us and will defend us to the end.
The Lord, the Holy Spirit, is among us.
He will lead us in God's holy way.
To God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be praise and glory today and forever. Amen.
So just a couple of notices before we finish our service today. This week there's the St. John's Coffee Morning at 10:30. That's over Zoom, so please do join in with that if you can. And you'll see on the pew leaflet all the information about our annual parochial church meeting, which is coming up in just a few weeks' time on the 26th of May. It's a Wednesday evening. It will be over Zoom, but there will be a very limited number of places in Church House for those who don't do internet things. So you need to book that with the parish office. There'll be information in next week's Pewslip about vacancies on the PCC and other elections that need to be had on that day. So please do keep a lookout for those. Thursday is Ascension Day. There'll be a service in St James at 10:30. Please do book if you want to come along to that. It also marks the beginning of that time of prayer that I mentioned in the sermon. You should have received or be receiving very soon this prayer journal, which gives you some readings and some thoughts for each day between Ascension and Pentecost, and perhaps will help you in your own prayer life. Please do use it. Kate and I are going away on holiday on next Saturday the 15th for a week. There will be a pre-recorded service for next Sunday. However, the week after, on the 23rd, which is Pentecost Sunday, we will be broadcasting the worship directly from the St James building onto the internet, onto YouTube. The access will be slightly different, but we'll give you all the information you need for that, so don't worry about that at all. What it does mean, though, is that you can't watch the service before it happens. You won't be able to watch it until after 10:30. You can watch it live at 10:30 or any time afterwards on YouTube or on the phone line. So please do look out for that. We'll give all the information in next week's Pewslip and the one after. So our final prayer of blessing today. May the love of the Lord Jesus draw you to himself. The power of the Lord Jesus strengthen you in his service. The joy of the Lord Jesus fill your hearts. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
And we finish today with a lovely hymn, Before the Throne of God Above.